One of the things I think y'all know that we've been working on with Allegheny County to try and get amendments to the building code, the plumbing code, to allow for all gender bathrooms to facilitate it, because it's become an obstacle to getting that done. And we know that this is really an important aspect of non-discrimination and inclusivity. So maybe you might be able to talk a little bit about why are non-gendered bathrooms important?
I could definitely say, speaking from my own personal experience, at least for me, one of the most nerve-wracking things to do as a queer person, like sexuality wise queer, let alone someone who is non-binary or trans, is to enter a specific gendered space. It was the thing I hated the most about high school, when I had to take pee and go into the locker room, because that's where a lot of harassment can occur. And that becomes extremely complicated when you're non-binary. It becomes really uncomfortable because sometimes people are looking at the way you dress and maybe can't put you in that male or female category, which obviously I'm not going for either. But it's because we do have gendered bathrooms, it's very jarring for people. And it doesn't matter which bathroom I pick. Almost inevitably, I'm stared at. And all I'm trying to do is use the bathroom and wash my hands. I don't need people to be staring at me. I don't want comments. I just want to, you know, use the restroom like everyone else. So I think that's part of the reason why having gender-neutral restrooms, like all gender restrooms where people of any gender can use them, and there's many different formats that can work in. But at the end of the day, as long as you're not putting that gender out there, then that removes that burden. Further, I hate having to go into a men's or a women's bathroom because I feel like I am gendering myself, and I don't want to gender myself. I don't want to have someone see me walk into a certain restroom and then make assumptions from there about what my gender is and what my pronouns are, which unfortunately often does happen. So it removes a lot of other things that aren't, you know, necessarily directly tied to the bathroom, but it really does speak to how pervasive binary gender is in our culture, that even the simple act of going to the restroom becomes a lot more than it really should.
I will also say too, in addition to being helpful for people of a variety of genders, all gender bathrooms are also really needed and properly labeled for the number of seated toilets, standing you know, devices, and also changing tables will be really helpful to people on the outside. Because yes, we are thinking especially in the context of a variety of genders, but also thinking about that intersection too, like families. You know, where can I take a, you know, a small child to help them use the restroom if they need help, if I need a changing table to, you know, get them all cleaned up. And also to people who have physical disabilities. And I don't want to say it like these are separate groups. Like there is a lot of overlap with all of these populations. And, you know, so it's not just all gender bathrooms just for, you know, the hell of it, but all gender bathrooms, because that's what our families need. That's what our population deserves. And also to even just if you did want to dive into the history, and I won't do it here, I won't do it to y'all, but if you look at the history of why we even have gendered bathrooms to begin with, it's mostly rooted in racism and sexism, you know, as far as who gets to use the restroom and who doesn't get to use the restroom and who is this space created for. So it's not just a matter of being inclusive towards all genders, but also being inclusive towards all abilities and all families, too.